In this video, I'll walk through an example of solution stoichiometry, specifically gravimetric analysis, where I'll find the percent by mass of an element in an unknown compound. A sample of 0.5430 grams of an unknown compound containing barium ions, Ba2+, is dissolved in water treated with an excess of Na2SO4. If the mass of the BaSO4 precipitate formed is 0.3205 grams, what is the percent by mass of barium in the original compound? Well, let's talk about first what it is we're looking for, and that is percent barium. So percent barium in the initial sample, that's this sample. Well, that equals the mass of the barium divided by the mass of the sample. And that is then multiplied by 100%, so you get your percent. And the mass of the sample is this 0.5430, so I'll write that right here, 0.5430, just so we don't confuse that later on. I better put grams there, 0.5430 grams. Okay. Then what we need is the mass of the barium. We have the mass of the sample, 0.5430. We need to find the mass of the barium. What we have is the mass of the precipitate. So we can find then, knowing the chemical formula of the barium sulfate, the BaSO4, knowing that formula, we can find the amount of, or the mass of the barium in this sample, because we're given the formula and the mass of the sample. By the way, this Na2SO4 may be interesting if you're doing more with this problem and you want to know what it is that it mixed with, but this is a red herring. You're not going to use that Na2SO4 in any part of solving this problem. Okay, so finding the mass of the barium in the BaSO4. Well, first of all, let's find what percent of barium is in the BaSO4. So I'll write that down. Percent barium in the BaSO4. And that equals the molar mass of barium divided by the molecular mass of this molecule, the BaSO4. Molecular mass of the BaSO4. And of course that's multiplied by 100% to give the percent. So that is equal to 137.3 is the molar mass. 137.3 grams is the molar mass of barium, and then I'll just kind of jump to this. We've got one barium, one sulfur, and four oxygens, so that is a molecular mass of 233.37 grams for the barium sulfate, the BaSO4. Dividing those, then, you get I'll write this as a percent because I have the 100% written there. That's 58.8336 1186%. I'm hanging on to all these decimal places. I'm just going to round at the end. Now, as a decimal, we'd move the decimal point back two places, but as a percent, we've got 58.8%. Okay, now that we have the percent of barium, now we can find the mass of the barium in this precipitate. So the mass of the barium in the BaSO4 sample. Well, that equals the percent of the barium multiplied by the mass of the sample. Mass of the BaSO4 sample. I'll put that on the next line, so that is percent as a decimal now, so it's 0.58833611186 multiplied by the mass of the sample, which is 0.3205, and we get approximately 0.188562 grams of barium. Okay, that's not our answer yet, because what we want to know is the percent of barium in the unknown compound. But we do know, so far, we know how much barium was in the original compound. So all we have to do is now we can plug in what our unknown was up here, and that is the mass of the barium. We found how much barium was being contributed to this new precipitate, this barium sulfate that formed. So I'm going to put that in a slightly darker blue up here, and I'll put that mass of the barium, 0.188562 grams of barium, over the mass of the sample, which was 0.5430 grams. And of course, I'll multiply it by the 100% right away. So now I will round to four decimal places, or four significant digits, and that comes to 34.73% barium by mass. That's in the original sample, not the precipitate, but this original unknown compound. I hope that helped. If you found this video helpful, as always, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.